After watching the movie Wild Ones on Netflix with my wife, the question came to mind, is the movie really based on a real experiment, the so-called the Philip experiment? A quick research left us with more questions than answers. The movie The Quiet Ones is supposedly a film based on the events of the Toronto Psychic Research Society in the 1970s, where parapsychologists try to recreate a ghost to prove they are products of human mind. But that's not what the movie presented. According to the official website, the movie is inspired by true events. An Oxford professor, along with the team university students, conduct an experiment on Jane, a young girl who hides some secrets. Jane has no memory of her past. She believes being possessed by the doll named Evie that gives her power. Keeping Jane awake in an isolated home, professors intend that she put her evil energy into an actual doll, thereafter destroying the doll and healing Jane. But what dark force they uncover are even terrifying than any of them expected. You can watch the trailer on the link below. Good, but what is the story behind the so-called Philip experiment? Dr. Alan George Robert Owen, a self-proclaimed ghost expert, created the group. It consists of his wife, an industrial designer, an accountant, a housewife, and a student psychology. A psychologist named Dr. Joan Witham also participated as an observer. The Canadian group aimed for the experiment that would have created a ghost. They wanted to prove the theory that the ghost is a product of the human mind. The experiment, which became known as the Philip experiment, began in 1972. The first objective was to create a fictional historical character. They created facts to relate to his life. They wrote a biography and called him Philip A. Lesford. In his biography, they claimed that he was a 17th century English nobleman who was married to a beautiful but cold and hostile woman by the name Dorothea. Philip then met a beautiful gypsy by the name Margot, who made him fall instantly in love. Soon, Philip and Margot became secret lovers. Dorothea, of course, found out about Margot and accused her of witchcraft. As a result, Margot was burned alive. Philip, plagued with remorse, and the only way he could handle it was fighting in the Battle of Dignitan, where he died on the battlefield. With the help from a biography sketch artist that execute freehand drawing of their newly created man, the group move on to the next phase, communicating. The objective that with Philip's portrait, the group would easily believe that Philip really existed. The sessions began in September 1972. The group discussed Philip's life, trying to visualize it with most detail as possible. For a year, the session didn't present no result, apart from the occasional presence in the room feeling, until the group decided to take a different approach. They changed the atmosphere to something more close to traditional seance, dimming the lights while sitting around a table. They include elements from Philip's area. For the surprise of part of the group, this technique produced the expected result. Philip manifests himself to the group. They got the first message from Philip in the form of a very clear beat on the table. They ask his questions, in which he could respond with a tap for yes and two to no. Is this really Philip? But how could they be sure it was Philip's ghost answering the questions? They decide to directly ask for questions from Philip's biography. As a result, Philip was able to give accurate information from his history. The science continues with a large range of unexplained phenomena. Philip began to assume personality of his own, with strong points of view on various subjects. Beside the blows on the table, he began moving the table, sliding from side to side, even over the thick rug. During Philip's manifestation, the group took notice of some singular characteristics. The table would be electric to touch, and the temperature would drop over the table. It was as if Philip, in a way, became the table itself. In front of a live audience of about 50 people, Philip made the lights flickering and even made the table levitate just an inch from the floor. All filmed as a part of the commentary that you can watch soon. The film experiment ran according to the initial expectations from the group. But against the main goal, the ghost of Philip never materialized in front of the group. What are the conclusion about the Philip experiment? Well, even after the long time and strange events documented by the Toronto Society, the results are inconclusive. Seems like some believes that it proves that ghosts does not exist, that they are simply creation of the mind. Others theorize that it might not have been Philip, but another ghost playing with the researchers. Outsiders, they just believe that it's all a hoax. But the question that brings us here to this video, is the movie The Quiet Ones based on the Philip experiment? Is there any truth between the film and the experiment? The connections are too slim. Beside the fact that the script has heavily rewrite for budget reasons, it's just an idea in there. It's just an idea of experiment with paranormal activities in this movie. It's a fictional movie inspired but not based on true events. Thanks for watching, and if you like to know more stories like that, check our website, strangestrangestrange.com.